गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई मिस महुआ बिस्वास, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन श्री विट्ठल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग पंढरपुर, वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर द सेशन ऑन डेटा नेटवर्क. बिफोर मूव टू द मेन कंटेंट, फर्स्ट यू मस्ट नो अबाउट द data network or data communication. So data communication refers to the exchange of data between a source and a receiver via a form of transmission medium such as wire cable or wireless. Data communication is said to be local if communicating devices are in the same building or a similarly restricted geographical area. The meaning of source and receiver are very simple. The device that transmits the data is known as source, and the device that receives the transmitted data is known as receiver. Data communication aims at the transfer of data and maintenance of the data during the process, but not the actual generation of the information at the source and the receiver. The term data used to describe information under whatever form of words you will be using. A data communication system may collect data from remote locations through data transmission circuits and then outputs processed result to remote locations. The different data communication techniques which are presently in widespread use evolved gradually either to improve the data communication techniques already existing or to replace the same with better options and features. So there are main three components of data communication. First one is sender, receiver, and the medium. So let's see one by one. What is a sender? It is a device or computer or any devices that generates and sends that message. Next is a receiver. It is a device or computer that receives the message. The location of receiver computer is generally different from the sender computer. The distance between the sender and receiver depends upon the types of network used in between. And third component is the medium. It is the channel or physical path through which the message is carried from sender to the receiver. The medium can be wired like twisted pair wire, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable, or wireless like laser, radio waves, and microwaves. In this way, the data is transmitted. Next is the transmission modes. So transmission modes refers to the mechanism of transferring of data between two devices connected over a network. It is also known as communication mode. These modes direct the direction of flow of information. So there are three types of transmission modes, and these are: first one is the simplex mode, second one is the half duplex mode, and third one is the full duplex mode. Let's see one by one. In simplex type of mode of transmission, data can be sent only in one direction, that is, communication is unidirectional. We cannot send a message back to the sender. Unidirectional communication is done in simplex systems where we just need to send a command or signal and do not expect any response back. So some of the examples of simplex mode of transmission are loudspeakers, television broadcasting, television and remote, keyboard and monitor. So there are so many examples which comes under the simplex mode of transmission. Next is the half duplex mode. In the case of half duplex transmission mode, data can be transmitted in both directions on a single carrier, but not at the same time. For example, on a local area network using a technology that has half duplex transmission, one workstation can send data on the line and then immediately receive data on the line from the same direction in which data was just transmitted. Hence, half duplex transmission implies a bidirectional line, but data can be sent in only one direction at a time. Some of the examples of half duplex is walkie-talkie, in which message is sent one at a time, but messages are sent in both the directions. A third mode of transmission is full duplex mode, where we can send data in both the directional as it is bidirectional at the same time. In other words, we can say that data can be sent in both directions simultaneously. Some of the examples of full duplex is telephone network, in which there is communication between two persons by a telephone line, using which both can talk and listen at the same time. In full duplex system, there can be two lines, one for sending the data and other for receiving the data. So this is some view of simplex and full duplex mode of transmission. So in simplex mode, only we can transmit the data, we cannot receive the data. But in the case of your full duplex mode of transmission, we not only transmit the data, we can also receive the data at a time. Next is a forms of data communication. So generally, there are two forms of data communication. First one is the analog data transmission forms, and second one is the digital transmission mode. Let's see one by one. Let's start with the analog transmission. So an analog signal is characterized by using is characterized by being continuously variable along both amplitude and frequency. In case of telephony, when we speak into a handset, our voice is converted into current or voltage fluctuations. Those fluctuations in current are an analog transmission of the actual voice pattern. To transmit an analog signal effectively, we need to define the frequency in which it operates. In telephony, the usual voice frequency band ranges from 300 Hz to 3400 Hz, and so the network provider will allocate a bandwidth of around 4000 Hz for voice transmission. Because of the limited bandwidth, analog facilities have and they cannot support high speed data transmission. But in the case of your digital transmission, digital signals are much simpler than analog signals. Instead of a continuous waveform, analog signals are made up of a series of pulses, or you can say series of pulses, that represent either 1 bit or 0 bit. Each computer system uses a coding scheme which defines that combinations of ones and zeros make up all the characters in the character set. The data are carried throughout the network depending on whether it is an electrical or optical transmission system. So this is all about the forms of data transmission. I hope you like this session. Thank you so much. All the best.